Before we begin today, I'd like to take a moment of silence for the 6 million Jews and the 11 million people who died in the Holocaust at the hands of the Nazis. May we never, ever forget their sacrifice, and may their memory forever be a blessing. Let us take a moment of silence. Shalom. It is my great honor and distinct privilege to speak with you today in this most esteemed chamber. They say speaking truth is good for the soul, so I'd like to begin today by speaking a little truth to power. People don't like you. People do not like politicians, but not out of hate or malice or even contempt, but out of disappointment. Disappointment that you can affect more change in one day than most people can throughout their entire lifetime. One day. That's not power. That is a sacred responsibility. I have pride in the people of Pennsylvania because the people of Pennsylvania make me proud. And we, the people, so desperately want to be proud of all of you. But to do that, we must cast away these false political divisions that seek to divide us rather than unite us. We must cast away these outside and improper influences that seek to corrupt this chamber through money and favors. And we must cast away the hate that's being used as a rallying cry in place of the love and hope that is meant to inspire. A famous rabbi once said, "The most important verse of all scripture was to love thy neighbor, that everything else was just commentary." So I will ask of you, will you love thy neighbor? Will you love someone who doesn't look like you or talk like you or love like you? Because in these divided times, that is our mountaintop, that is our moon. For the issues we face today are far too great and numerous not to try and solve them today. Education, immigration, poverty, homelessness, civil rights, disability rights, mental health, and the opiate epidemic, these are not political issues. These are people issues. And it's incumbent upon us to try and solve them today. Not tomorrow, not a month from now, not a year from now, and not in the next election cycle, but today. And I have faith. I have faith that we can be known as a state of compassion. I have faith that we can be known as a state willing to fight hard battles for the sake of good people's lives. But maybe I'm a fool. Maybe I'm naive as we stand in the shadows of this new era in American politics, where a dark cloud has descended upon our great nation, providing cover for anger and bitterness and division. But when you stand under a cloud of hate, you get rained on. Because hate is a disease, it is a virus, it infects and it spreads. And the only cure for hate has always ever been and will always ever be love. Love. And love grows like a seed into an oak tree. Like a butterfly flapping its wings in the Pacific, causing a hurricane in the Atlantic, it grows. And we can grow it right here, right now, today. They say one act can change the world. I don't know if that's true. But what I do know is true is that one act can change someone's world. And that should be our goal. That should be our mission. So I will pray for you and I will bless you and say, may God bless you. May God keep you and guard you. May God lift his face upon you and shine his light upon you. May God make you gracious and may he grant you peace. But more, may God grant you strength. May God grant you strength to stand firm, not only to your political basis, but to the base instincts that reside within all of us that seeks to divide rather than unite. For when we can truly love thy neighbor, then we will truly be acting in the image of God. So I pray. I pray. Amen.
Representative McClinton, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I rise for just a few moments to acknowledge my guest chaplain of today, Rabbi Michael Perice. Michael's journey to becoming a rabbi is both interesting and unique. When Michael was a boy, his rabbi committed a serious crime and he was driven away from the Jewish life. Over the next decade, Michael lived as a secular Jew, only attending high holy day services each year with his grandmother. As an undergrad, Michael received degrees in political science and American history at Temple University. While at Temple, he worked on several political campaigns, but chose not to ultimately pursue a career in politics. After embarking on a spiritual quest, Michael reconnected with his faith and his Jewish roots. He then decided to travel to Israel, where he studied Hebrew and Jewish studies for a year. It was then Michael decided to pursue his calling as a rabbi. Since that time, he has worked in many synagogues, but recently served as the education director and student rabbi for congregation Beth Tikva in Marlton, New Jersey, where he was named one of the top 20 emerging leaders in the South Jersey region. Michael currently works as a senior Jewish educator at the University of Delaware, Hillel, where he serves a Jewish population of over 2,000 students. He's receiving his rabbinic ordination from the Reconstructionist Rabbinical College in Philadelphia and is expected to graduate in 2019. He currently resides in the Mount Airy section of Philadelphia. Most recently, Mr. Speaker, I was the keynote speaker for Martin Luther King Day Memorial and Interfaith Service, and that's where I met the rabbi. I'm thrilled to have him today. He's here with his lovely fiance, Rachel Burgess, and his parents are in the back, Eileen and Salvatore Perice. I'd ask that they would stand so we could give them a hearty welcome and thank him for his awesome prayer. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Rabbi, your journey is inspiring, and we wish you all the best in your mission to so many good people, particularly the youth in our country. God bless you.